This is where the old me dies. Light a match, let it burn, kiss it goodbye. Giving up what I was, this is where I draw the line. That I kept in, locked inside my heart. Every single regret, every misstep, they kept me in the dark. Now I stand face to face with the light of your grace, where the weight of all my shame begins to fall once and for all. Once and for all.
If there are any prodigals in this room tonight, any prodigal sons and prodigal daughters, I love the story of the prodigal son because he had this, he left home and went away and spent all of his inheritance on wild living, yep. And ended up spending everything that he had, starving to death, and was like, I just need to go home. And that's what happens a lot of times whenever we walk away from God in our lives, and we end up just wasting it on the world, and we end up starving to death spiritually, and we know that we need to go home. And the story of the prodigal son is like he had this great speech prepared. He'd been working on it for days on his way home, and he had this great speech prepared. He was like going to say, Father, I'm no longer worthy to be called your son if you'll just let me be one of the lowliest servants in your house. Just, I'm starving to death. If you just let me be one of your servants, it'll be enough. If you'll just take me back home, forgive me. And as the story goes, the son is coming home, and the father sees him from way off. And the father takes off and sprints to him. And the son's got this speech prepared. He's been preparing it for days, and he's working on it. The father comes up, and the son's he's nervous, you know. He's the speech he's working on. He's like, I got to say it right. I only get one chance of this. And he's like, Father, I've sinned before heaven and in your sight. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. If you just let me be one of your lowliest servants, I'm starving to death, and I know it'll be enough if you just let me be your servant. If you just take me back home and forgive me. And I love the father's response because he absolutely ignored every single word that the son said. The son had been preparing this speech for days. He at least could have had enough respect to at least listen to his speech. No, he absolutely ignored every single word of it and shouted and exclaimed, my son who was dead is now alive. And tonight I'm telling you, if you're far away from home, when you take that one step back to him, he will sprint to you, he will run to you, and I know you've got a great speech prepared that you've been preparing for days, weeks, and years, and he's going to ignore every single word of it, and he's going to wrap you up in his arms, and he's going to say, my son, my daughter, who was dead, is now alive. And if you're thinking about turning around and coming home tonight, I want you to know this is what God's word to you would be. He would say, whatever reason you've been running, I just don't care anymore. I've already forgotten whatever happened with what went wrong. I just want you to come home. 'Cause I'm the one that you've been looking for. I'm the one that you've been waiting for. I've had my eyes on you ever since you were born. Oh, I will love you after the rain falls down. I will love you after the sun goes out. I'll have my eyes on you after the world is no more. Tonight, if you're struggling with losing a lost loved one, it's something that we all struggle with, man. It's a part of life. None of us like it. You know, every single one of us in this room, every single one of us one day, we're going to die. And we all know that we're going to die, but we don't want to think about it. We don't want to talk about it. And when someone that we love dies, we're completely surprised. Yep. Completely shocked. Because we don't like the way that it happened, and we naturally will get mad at God every single time. We'll get mad and we'll say, why did you do this? Every single time. I wish I had a solution to that. I don't. I just know that it's a part of life. And I know it's a part of life that I guarantee you somebody in this room is going through right now. And if that's you tonight, this song's for you. If you fly away tonight, I want to tell you that I love you. I hope that you can hear me. I hope that you can feel me. If you fly away tonight, I want to tell you that I'm sorry that I never told you when we were face to face. But for those of us that die in Jesus Christ, that die as a son of God, as a daughter of God, as a child of God, this life is not the end. The time that we close our eyes in this world is not the end. The time that we stop breathing for the last time is not the end. It is actually the beginning. It is actually the beginning for those of us that die in the Lord. It is actually the beginning, because the very next time that we open our eyes, the very next time we breathe, we'll be in a place where the desert is covered in roses, where I can outshine the stars in a single day, and the face of God isn't heated when I wake into eternity. The shadows are never discovered. Our tears are nothing more than a memory. Death isn't alive any longer. Death isn't alive any longer. Death isn't alive in eternity. God will be with us then, and God is with us now. If you know this song, I want you to sing it with me tonight. Everybody, sing.
Their words cannot stand against us, for God is with us.
Shout it.
God is with us. This desert is a wicked place. I'm weary from this wretched chase. So where does my help come from?
God is with us.
lift your hands for me tonight.